Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Nanda Kumar. Today we shall discuss about KSET English Paper 2, which was held on 2016. This paper contains 50 questions. Each question carries 2 marks. Let me begin with the first question, that is, the epithet Marlowe Mighty Lines is used to describe Marlowe's use of option A, blank verse, option B, iambic pentameter, option C, couplet, option D, octave rhyme. Let us know, friends, what it is. Blank verse is a kind of poetry written in unrhymed lines. It is always in iambic pentameter, and Christopher Marlowe was the first author to write a blank verse in his writings. So the right answer is option A, blank verse is the right answer. Question number 2. The members of Imagist group were Rupert Brooke, Amy Lowell, T.E. Hume, Richard Aldington. You know, friends, the Imagist school is a group of American and English poets which was originated in early 20th century, and Ezra Pound was the leader of this group. And the other Imagist poets are Amy Lowell, T.E. Hume and Richard Aldington. So the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 3. Match the following. Jane Austen wrote the novel Northern Abbey, published in 1817. Charlotte Bronte wrote the novel Jane Eyre, published in 1871. Elizabeth Gaskell has written the novel North and South, which was published in 1851. Mary Wollstonecraft wrote Franston novel, published in 1818. So here the right answer is option A is the right answer. Question number 4. The term stream of consciousness is first used in the writings of option A, Sigmund Freud, option B, William James, option C, Carl Jung, option D, Virginia Woolf. Stream of consciousness is a term originated in early 19th century. The term first used by the psychologist William James in his book The Principles of Psychology, published in 1819, which means describe the character's inner thought. So the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 5. In Ode to Nightingale, which expression brings the poet back to the real world? Option A, cold pastoral, option B, Florana, option C, warm south, option D, hungry generation. Here the right answer is option B, forlorn is the right answer. Question number 8, match the following. Leopold Bloom is a fictional character in the novel Ulysses by James Joyce. Paul Morrell is a character of D.H. Lawrence novel Sons and Lover. Crudge is a central character in Joseph Conrad novel Heart of Darkness. Scooby is a character in Graham Greene's novel The Art of Matter. So the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 7. Humankind cannot bear very much reality. Who says this in The Murder in Cathedral? A, option A, the Chorus, B, the Priest, option C, the First Temper, option D, Beckett. You know, friends, Murder in Cathedral is a verse drama by T.S. Eliot that portrays the assassin of Archbishop Thomas Beckett in Canterbury Cathedral during the reign of Henry II. Edward Grimm, a clerk who is an eyewitness of the event. So these lines are told by Thomas Beckett. So the right answer is option D, Beckett. Question number 8. The protagonist in the novel Disgrace is a professor of economics, philosophy, English, mathematics. Disgrace is a novel by J.M. Codge, published in 1999. It won Booker Prize. also the writer also awarded Nobel Prize in Literature. David Lurie is a protagonist in the novel who is the professor of English. So the right answer is option C, English. Midterm Break by Seamus Heaney, about the death of her father, the death of her younger brother, the death, the famine in Ireland. Option B, the Irish Rebellion. You know friends, Midterm Break is a poem by Seamus Heaney, Irish poet. The poem is all about Heaney's brother who was killed by the car in 1953 when he was only 4 years old. The poem describes the unexpected griefs of his family. So the right answer is option B, the death of younger brother. Option, question number 10. Read the following statement and choose the reason given for it. Choose the right option, response. Assertion: Lady Macbeth goads Macbeth to kill Duncan. Reason: she does so because she is devoid of any human feelings. Here the right answer is option D is the right answer. A is true but R is false. Question number 11. Which of the following poem is not written by Salvia Plath? You know friends, Salvia Plath was an American poet, novelist, as well as short story writer. She awarded Pulitzer Prize in Poetry in 1982, who is best known for her poems, poetry collections, The Colossus and other poems, Ariel, as well as The Bell Jar. The Bell Jar is a semi-autobiographical novel. Here all poems were written by Salvia Plath. Right, question number 12. Identify the work of Francis Bacon related to the science. Option A, Utopia. Option B, an essay concerning human understanding. Option C, Novum Organum. Option D, The Complete Anger. The Novum Organum is a philosophical work by Francis Bacon, published in 1620. The title refers to the Aristotle work Organon, which is a treatise on logic and symbolism. So the right answer is option C, Novum Organum. Question number 13. T.S. Eliot considers Hamlet an inferior work because it has a lost plot, the characters are not fully developed, it contains excessive violence, the author's intention is not related. You know friends, Hamlet and His Problems is an essay by T.S. Eliot in which he comment on Shakespeare Hamlet due to its lack of objectivity, as well as the author intention is not related in that drama. So the right answer is option D is the right answer. Question number 14. Post-colonial readings of Tempest designate Caliban as a noble savage, B, a willing victim, C, the resistance colonized, option D, a romantic dreamer. Here the right answer is option C is the right answer. The post-colonial critics view that the Prosperous and Miranda related to the Caliban as an allegory of European colonialism. So in the play, Caliban represents as colonized. So the right answer is option C, the resistant colonized is the right answer. Question number 15. Which of the following work is not written by Herman Melville? Here the right answer is option C, An Outcast of the Iceland. You know friends, An Outcast of the Iceland, a novel by Joseph Conrad, published in 1894. The novel tells about the fall of Peter Williams, who is a bad man and has a bad reputation. So the right answer is option C is the right answer. Question number 16. The protagonist in the namesake is named after Russian writer Antony Chivonko. Option B, Maxim Gorky. Option C, Vladimir. Option D, Nikolai Gogol. You know, friends, the name Shake is a novel by Jhumpa Lahiri, published in 2003. The story begins with Ashok and Ashima Ganguly, a young Bengali couple, lived in Calcutta and settled in Cambridge, Massachusetts, at Boston. Ashok is an engineering student at Massachusetts Institution of Cambridge. Ashim, who is a wife of Ashok, struggle for her language as well as her cultural barriers, because one more she had a fear of her delivery of a first child alone, so she delivers a child. According to the Bengal culture, the child have two names, one name for family and a good name for public. So Ashok suggested the name of Gogol, in honor to the famous Russian author Nikolai Gogol. So the right answer is option D is the right answer. Question number 17. Martin is the pen name of Samuel L. Claudius, Samuel L. Clemens, Samuel L. Bowman, Samuel L. Zimmerman. Here the right answer is option C is the right answer. Sorry, option B is the right answer. Samuel L. Clemens. Question number 18. Which of the following novel by Alice Walker is an epistory novel? The Tempest of My Familiar, Meridian, C, The Color Purple, option D, Possessing the Secret of Joy. Alice Walker was an American novelist known for her notable work The Color Purple. It is an epistory novel published in 1982. It won the Pulitzer Prize as well as the National Award. The novel is about a poor, uneducated girl, Celia, living in United States. She writes a letter to God because her father, Alfonso, beats her and rapes her. Alfonso has already impregnated Celia once, which resulted in the birth of a boy, Adam. So Celia thinks that Alfonso kills Adam. So the novel is all about the exploitation of a woman. So the right answer is option C is the right answer. Question number 19. The prologue in Dr. Faustus makes reference to the myth. Option A, Icarus. Option C, Prometheus myth. Option C, Orpheus myth. Option D, Rebellious Angel. Here the right answer is option C, Icarus myth. The tragical history of life and death of Dr. Faustus, which was commonly known as Dr. Faustus, is an Elizabethan tragedy by Christopher Marlowe, which was based on the German scholar Faustus, who becomes dissatisfied with the limited traditional form of knowledge, such as logic, medicine, law, religion, and philosophy. So he decided to learn magic or necronomy, but he has to sold his soul to devil in exchange of knowledge to a magical power. So there are two angels in the tragedy. Good angel who tries to convince Faustus not to pursue magic, but the evil angel encourages him to pursue the magic. So later Faustus agrees to sold his soul to the Lucifer, and he learned magic. Later, Faustus did so many unlawful things with the help of magic. At the end of the tragedy, the chorus delivers an epilogue to conclude that the confirming Faustus has fallen to hell, and telling the audience that to learn from Faustus' example, not to learn the unlawful things, so beyond the limits of appropriate human knowledge. The prologue in the Dr. Faustus make a reference to the Greek myth Icarus. So the right answer is option A is the right answer. क्वेश्चन नंबर 20, विच अमेरिकन पोएट लिरिसिस्ट कंपोज्ड द सॉन्ग लाइक अ रोरिंग स्टोर. हियर द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी, बॉब डिलन इज द राइट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 21, इन कोलरिजस कुबला खान द लाइन्स waves a circle around him thrice refers to option A, Kubla Khan, option B, the marker of the summer palace, option D, the poet, option T, Kubla Khan's ancestor. Kubla Khan or a vision in a dream is a poem by S.T. Coleridge published in 1816. In the first part of the poem, the speaker described the beauty of Xanadu. It is an summer palace of Kubla Khan. So the right answer is option C is the right answer. Question number 2. Dr. Johnson claimed in his plan for the dictionary that he would fix the English language in 3 years. To whom did he write it? Option A, Boswell. Option B, Lord Chesterfield. Option C, his publishers. Option D, Edward Coker. Here the right answer is Lord Chesterfield is the right answer. A Dictionary of English Language is a book by Dr. Samuel Johnson, published in 1755. It was among the first influential dictionary in the history of English language. So the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 23. Who among the following is not a university vet? Robert Greene, John Lilly, Christopher Marlowe, John Webster. Here the right answer is John Webster is the right answer. John Webster is not an university vet, but he is an English Jacobean dramatist known for his tragedy The White Devil and The Duchess of Malfi. Question number 24. In The Rape of Locke, when Belinda wakes up, her eyes fallen on option A, her cosmetics, option B, her love letters, option C, her golden rings, option D, her silken gown. The Rape of Locke is a poem by Alexander Pope. It is a mock epic poem published in 1712. The poem is based on the real incident of the poet's friend John Carlyle. The poem begins with Belinda, a beautiful and wealthy young woman, is asleep. When she wakes up, her eyes falls on the love letters. So the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 25. When lovely woman stoops to folly, this is a song which originally appears in Rasselas, She Stoops to Conquer, A Vicar of Wakefield, The Country Wife. Here the right answer is The Vicar of Wakefield is a novel by Oliver Goldsmith. Option C is the right answer. Question number 26. Match the following. Stella is Sydney's lover, star lover. Annie Bowley is related to Thomas Watt. Fanny Burney is the beloved of John Keats. Shakespeare's some sonnets are dedicated to the dark lady. So the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 27. In the title The Citizen of the World, Oliver Goldsmith adopts the mask of a Chinese philosopher, a Persian scholar, Greek traveler, and a Russian diarist. The Citizen of the World is a collection of letters written by Oliver Goldsmith from the perspective of Lin Chi Altinger, a Chinese philosopher. So the right answer is option A, a Chinese philosopher. Question number 28. Every man I will go with thee and be thy guide. This line from the play Every Man is spoken by good deeds, fellowship, knowledge, pleasure. Here the right answer is option C, pleasure. Question number 29. He was the man who of all modern and perhaps an ancient poets had the largest and most comprehensive soul. This tribute to Shakespeare was paid by Dr. Johnson, Milton, Ben Jonson, Dryden. Here the right answer is John Dryden is the right answer. Question number 30. But Rich was of holy thought and work. The narrator of the prologue to Contemporary Tales says this of the monk, Parsana, Summoner, Franklin. Here the right answer is option B. Person is the right answer. Question number 31. Earth felt the wound and nature from her seat. Singing through all her works gave singe of woe that all was lost. These lines describes the shock of Queen Elizabeth's death. Vision doomsday. Option C, the consequences of the original sin. And option D, the trump of Charles execution. Here the right answer is option C, the consequences of original sin is the right answer. Question number 32. The line, the better part of world war is discretion, figures in the play. Julius Caesar, Henry V, Richard II, Henry IV, part 1. Here the right answer is option D is the right answer. Henry IV, part 1. It is a historical play by Shakespeare. It is a trilogy of Shakespeare play, Henry IV, part 2 and Henry V. The play deals with the successive reign of Richard II. So the right answer is option D is the right answer. Question number 33. The complete title of Frederick Jameson's work is option A, Postmodernism and the Logic of High Capitalism. Option B, Postmodernism or the Logic of Global Capitalism. Option C, Postmodernism or the Cultural Logic of the Late Capitalism. Option D, Postcolonialism, Postmodernism as the Cultural Logic of Market Capitalism. Here the right answer is option C is the right answer. Postmodernism or the Cultural Logic of Late Capitalism is a book by Frederick Jameson published in 1991 in which the author offers the critique of modernism and postmodernism from the Marxist perspective. Right, question number 34. Name the critic who formulated the concept of interpretive communities. Option A, Wolfgang Iser. Option B, Frederick Jameson. Option C, Stanley Fish. Option D, Norman Holland. Here the right answer is option C, Stanley Fish is the right answer. Interpretive communities are the theoretical concepts stemming from reader response to criticism by Stanley Fish. Reader response theory believes that the idea of a reader's experience can affect the understanding of the text, and Stanley Fish in his essay Interpreting the Verium, he examines how the interpretation of a text is depends upon the each reader's subjective experience. So the right answer is option C is the right answer. Question number 35. Match the following. Stephen Greenblatt is associated with the new criticism. New historicism. J.C. Ransom is associated with New Criticism Theory. Sartre Hall is associated with Cultural Studies. Alan Sinfield is associated with Cultural Materialism. here the right answer is option A is the right answer. Question number 36. Here God plenty. Here is God plenty. Dryden made this remark about Shakespeare plays, Chaucer's Canterbury Tales, Milton's Paradise Lost, Dante Divine Comedy. Here the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 37. Good morrow to the day, the next my gold. This line occurs in The Jew of Malta, B. Wolfone, option C. The Duchess of Amalfi, option C. Shoemaker's Holiday. Here the right answer is option B is the right answer, Wolfone. Wolfone is a comedy by Ben Jonson, published in 1606. The play is about the money and the power of its influence on people. So the right answer is option B. Question number 38. It was the best of the time, it was the worst of the time. This opening line from Dickens' A Tale of Two Cities is in prose, but it follows the exact pattern of option A, trochic meter, option B, papistic, option C, iambic meter, option D, dactylic. Here the right answer is option C, iambic meter is the right answer. Question number 39. Darwin's influential work, The Origin of Species, was published in the year of option A 1859, option B 1849, option C 1865, option D 1860. On the Origin of Species is a book by Charles Darwin, published in 1859. It is a work of scientific literature. The author introduced the scientific theory that the population evolved over the course of generations through the process of natural selection. Here the right answer is option A is the right answer, 1859. Question number 40. Vandana Shiva's Staying Alive does not deal with the Green Revolution. Option B, Patriarchy and Capitalism. Option C, Religious Fundamentalism. Option D, The Idea of Progressive. Staying Alive is a book by Vandana Shiva in which she examines the position of women in relation to the nature. Here the right answer is option C, religious fundamentalism is not the theme of Staying Alive by Vandana Shiva. Question number 41. Our ground cosmographers and I their map. In which poem do you find this reference to the signs of the time? Option A, The Sun Rising. Option B, Thoughts in Garden. Option C, Hymn to God, My God in My Sickness. Option D, The Color. Hymn to God, My God is My Sickness. In My Sickness, it is a devotional poem by John Donne. The poem is about the sickness condition of the poet who feels that he is going to die, but he has no fear for death. He has led a good life, and now it is time to move from a misery of a bliss. So the theme of this poem are redemption, forgiveness, mercy, suffering, and spirituality. So the right answer is option C, Hymn to God, My God in My Sickness is the right answer. Question number 42. An image is an intellectual and emotional complex in one instant of time. This statement was made by T.S. Eliot, Ezra Pound, Kenneth Brook, I.A. Richardson. Here the right answer is Ezra Pound is the right answer. क्वेश्चन नंबर 43, whom ever loved, whom loved not at first sight, is an example of option A, rhetorical question, option B, an inverted question, option C, an ironical question, option D, paradox. Here the right answer is option A, a rhetorical question is the right answer. Question number 44. April is the cruelest month. This opening line of the Westland contains oxymoron, transport epithet, an allusion, personification. Here the right answer is it is an allusion. Right? Question number 45. Choose the correct chronological sequence in which of the work, which works are appeared. David Copperfield published in 1849, Bleak House published in 1852, Hard Time published in 1854, Our Mutual Friend published in 1865. Here the right answer is option D is the right answer. Option D is the correct chronological order of the novel. These novels were written by Charles Dickens. Question number 46. Which of the following critics formulated the performative theory of gender? Option A, Ellen Showalter. Option C, Gayatri Spivak. Option C, Judith Butler. And option D, Judith Wright. Here the right answer is Judith Butler is the right answer. Judith Butler's book, Notes Towards Performative Theory by Assembly, is published in 2015, in which she talks about the gender politics and freedom of assembly. So the right answer is option C is the right answer. Question number 47. Which of the following is not a dramatic monologue? Option A, Titonus. Option B, Ulysses. Option C, Maud. Option D, none. Here the right answer is option A. Option C, Maud is the right answer. It is a poem by Alfred Lord Tennyson, published in 1855. Question number 48. The line, then all smiles stopped together in my lost Duchess, suggests that the Duchess became serious and stopped smiling. Option B, she took the Duke warning to the stopping smile. Option C, the Duke had her killed. Option D, the Duchess abandoned the Duke. Here the right answer is option C, the Duke had killed her is the right answer. My Lost Duchess is a poem by Robert Browning, published in 1842. Question number 49. Match the following names of the woman character in the novels in which they appear. Sissy Joop is a fictional character in Dickens' novel Hard Time. Gwendolyn Harleth is a character in George Eliot novel Daniel Deronda. Isabella is a character in Emily Bronte's novel Wuthering Heights. Sharp is the character in Thackeray's novel Vanity Fair. Here the right answer is option B is the right answer. Question number 50. Who among the following is the author of Emma and the Big Room? Here the right answer is Jerry Pinto is the right answer. Jerry Pinto is an Indian English novelist as well as poet. The poem Emma and the Big Room is published in 2012. Right? Okay friends, if you have any doubts, confusions and clarifications, Let me know in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.